Hi, my name is Stefan, and today I want to share with you my reconstruction of an imbrachiatura as shown in Achille Marozzo's Opera Nova. For the selection of materials, I will use some modern counterparts to historic components, like plywood instead of wooden planks, wood glue instead of cheese glue, or cotton velvet instead of silk velvet, to keep it easier and more accessible. Also, this time I will make use of a jigsaw, to save some time cutting everything into shape. A detailed list of all the material I used will be linked in the video description. The inner body of the shield is made from two layers of plywood, glued together under tension to form the band. This one here was made by a friend Benny from my reenactment club. This spared me some discussions with my husband where to put it while it dries. The first steps, after finishing the core of course, is to mark the outline of the shield. After making sure it's symmetric, a jigsaw is used to cut it into shape. To make the shield more stable and also allow for a nice ground for later shield painting, I use linen textiles and glue it with wood glue onto the shield. To give it an according Renaissance look, I will use a piece of red velvet for the inside. So, what is an imbrachiatura anyway? The meaning of the word in Italian is something like strapped to the arm, shoulder. This is something we can already use to figure out how it's worn or the straps are configured. Also following the illustrations, the shield is about shoulder height, so we have already an idea what are the dimensions. There's a really nice video from the Fun DM Stage Gladiatores YouTube channel on the connection of the Pavese shield to this Renaissance shield. But even without this connection, I assume a rotella-like configuration. This can be supported by analyzing the two illustrations which are found in the woodcuts and copper plates of Achille Marozzo's Opera Nova. In both illustrations, a guardia e alta is shown, and if we compare this now with a depiction of guardia e alta with, for instance, the two swords section and overlaying them, we can see how the left arm would be arranged under the shield. Additionally, since the Bolognese system is a quite holistic approach, we find basically two kinds of shields in it. A center gripped shield like the buckler, the small or big buckler, and the targa, and the arm strap on a rotella, which as I also depicted. Basically, the Fun DM Stage Gladiatores channel and also the Chicago Swordplay Guild come to the same conclusion in their research. I will link both in the video description. The next step is to figuring out how the shield straps will be arranged and positioned directly on the shield. For this, I will use my arm to mark out the positions of the hand strap and the elbow strap. Once I have figured out the right position, I mark the spots and pre-drill holes, which later fit copper nails, which are used as rivets to hold leather stripes into place. Now I can rivet the straps into place. Basically, the shield is now finished, but to give it an according look, I continue now to give it a period-fitting paint job. I will use egg tempera as basis for my paint, together with mineral pigments. There's some really nice explanations which I will link in the video description how to prepare it, and also my fellow reconstructor Roland Watzecker recently published a video how he used this technique to paint his Viking shield. For the egg tempera, you have to extract the egg yolk and make sure that there's no skin or membrane getting into the mixture. Then an equal part of water and linseed oil is also mixed into it. A bit of steering and the basic egg tempera is finished. Basically two versions of this egg tempera can be found, with or without an oil. I will use linseed oil additionally to basically make a stronger coating. To achieve the nice colors, I will use mineral pigments, which I sourced locally here in a small shop nearby. I will link it also in the description because I have really nice pigments. I prepared an ultramarine blue, an iron oxide red, and an ochre gold yellow paint. Some markings before to make the painting easier, and I proceed to cover the front of the shield. The blue will be the connection to our reenactment club, the Berliner Rittergilde, and the red-yellow are the colors of Potsdam, where our HEMA group, the Schildwache, is located. Since this is a Renaissance shield, it will be used there for studying the Bolognese sauces. Now it just needs 1 to 2 days to dry, and then it will be finished. In the depictions of Achille Marozzi, you find that this shield has a spike in the end, which is probably made out of metal, the so-called brocca. But since I want to use this shield in sparring and to study the sources, I need a safe version. There are some nice ideas of fitting a rondel dagger to it, one of those plastic ones. But since I want to keep the historic look, I decided to make the brocca out of leather, similar to the Dussacs sold by the Jester of Blades. For this I take 4 pieces of leather. 2 pieces in the middle, which are around the thickness of the shield, and 1 top and bottom piece. I cut them into shape and glue them with contact cement to each other. Then I pre-drill holes in order to sew everything even tighter. Then I can continue sewing this to the shield, and this is finished. I hope you liked this. If you want to support us, consider subscribing and sharing the video so we can prepare more content like this. How do you build your shields for reenactment, HEMA, or living history? Let us know in the comments. So long, have a wonderful day.